Yes.
Okay. So, when did you start coming here to the club?
Oh my God, you want dates and names and dates.
Years.
Let's see.
Just, you know, years.
Yeah, that's a hard one, man. Let's see. I started doing comedy clubs in the early 80s. So, probably the early 80s. Were they opening there?
Early 82.
Is that when they opened?
Yeah. 82.
That's when I probably was there or close to. Because I graduated high school in 76, worked the streets for a couple years in San Francisco, then started doing comedy clubs. So probably in the early 80s.
And what is it about this club? I mean, I know you've been to a lot of clubs. What is it about this club? Why is it so?
Because the energy at this club is so much stronger than the other clubs that I played when I was doing clubs. It was just somewhere that you felt right connected to the audience. No matter how high or you could always manage to get a great laugh here. And I always said that someday I would shoot my special here. And when I finally did get a chance to do my special, I didn't do it here.
Now, you've been in Vegas for?
12 years. I was supposed to be there for 2 weeks. I was supposed to fill in for David Brenner at the Gold Nugget for 2 weeks. And we sold out every night, and they kept me for 12 years. So we've been out there for, we still go out there, we're still going. I just come out here to take a break from Vegas and do nightclubs again for six months. I'm doing one weekend every month at one of my favorite clubs.
And that would be?
That would be the Punchline. And not very many people are here that were there when I mean, Punchline's always known for holding on to their employees for a long, long time. And over the years that I played here, it was always the same family, you know, same people worked here. And, you know, I love Ronnie and Dave
and
Chris and Doug and everyone, you know. No one's here except for Marcy, which is, if someone's got to be here, Marcy's a good one to be here still. Me and Marcy, I think Marcy's great.
Okay, let's. You were here in the early days when it's the swinging 80s when everything.
Everybody was doing drugs and having sex, and it was before. It was before we looked really old like we do now. So, everybody. I mean, all the waitresses at the Punchline were hot, and back in those days. I made them think I was too, so I had a great time. It was sex, drugs, and rock and roll. And a lot of people stopped doing that. A lot of people died from doing that. A lot of people are still doing that. And that's what Punchline was about, man. It was. It had a good energy to it. I remember staying up for days and days and days, and then having to go to Atlantic City and do my pilot for Merv Griffin. I did a game show called Ruckus, and I'd been up for 3 days, and when I got to the hotel, I just wanted to sleep, and they had me in front of the cameras for 24 hours straight after being up for 3 days straight. And I was lost, man, I was trashed. But I don't regret any of it. Now everybody's all clean and nobody does. Once in a while, I hear someone smoking pot. I'm like, oh my God, they're smoking pot. You know, things have changed around here, which is good. I'm glad.
One thing that hasn't changed is the lovely decor here.
Yeah, it looks exactly the same, with the exception of the two giant LCD screens on stage. I don't even see where the carpet's been swept. So, look at this paneling. This paneling's great. I don't even think they sell this anymore. I think you can get like $50 for one panel on eBay for this stuff now. Yeah. It looks like someone's basement, doesn't it?
What is making tonight special for me is the fact that Amazing Jonathan is really in the first group of comedians who ever came through the Punchline all the way back in 1982. So it is a testament to him that he has had the longevity that he has had. He has been crushing it in Las Vegas. He's taken a little break. He's coming out and playing some of his favorite clubs. We were glad to be included on the list. But here's the thing. When I introduce him and I bring him out here on this stage, I'd like you to do me just one favor. I'd like you to make sure that if it's for another 25 years that he's headlining Vegas stages and comedy clubs, that he never, ever forgets what it sounds like on a Saturday night in the Punchline when the room is full. Would you do me a favor and please welcome to the stage my very good friend, the amazing Jonathan.
Good evening, and welcome to an evening of comedy with the amazing Jonathan. We feel that we must warn you that portions of the show do contain violence. They may also include adult language, nudity, graphic masturbation sketches.
I don't know, it just tastes salty. I won't
tap dancing crack babies.
I won't ever do that again.
And a like testicle salt. Stretching contest. Thank you, and enjoy the show.
I only did it one time. I didn't even know the guy. Fuck, is this mic on? It's mic on, isn't it? Fuck. Give me my bra.
Gentlemen, please welcome the Freddy Krueger of comedy and magic, the amazing Jonathan.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Wow. Thank you. All right. Sounded pretty fucking real, didn't it? That was just in case you didn't do it. I still had it. Fuck, I wish I had a better act. Well, welcome. This is great being back here. This is awesome. Look at this new piece of shit that I have. This is the $2,500 invisible microphone that I got this week. Oh. May have gotten fucked on this deal. Now, you can't see what I'm talking about, but there's actually a microphone. I could strap this to my head, and it would be less apparent than this. And I keep thinking somebody's next to me, too. I'm like, every second, I'm like, what the fuck? Right? When you're doing a lot of cocaine, that'll make you jittery. I bet. Well, let's start with a magic trick. Do you have a handkerchief? Can you do this for me, that? Well, it's distracting. I can't concentrate. Between this and that, I'm like, Well, we're going to actually go into the audience to try to find a volunteer who's willing to help me with a trick. Now, this can be anyone, so if you're out there, raise your hand so I know where you're sitting. You! I didn't even see you. Come on up. Give it up. It could be you. Give it up. Yeah, right over here. Okay, we got sound cues tonight? Yeah? Yeah. That's the one I was looking for. How are you?
Very good.
You need to stay on the trap door so you don't hit your chin on the way down. Good. Nice to... Fuck, you're tall, man. You weren't that tall sitting down there. To think twice about doing some of the shit. Jonathan.
Brandon.
No, Jonathan.
Brandon.
You're Brandon. Yes. Okay, I thought you were correcting me. I'm like, fuck, I know my own name. Well, this will be Mike, so there's no more confusion. Mike, that's Brandon. Brandon, that's Mike.
How you doing, Mike?
Pretty good, Brandon. How are you?
I'm doing great.
That was me. I'm fucking with you. Isn't that cool? It's ventriloquism. I'm studying it. Watch. Look that way and move your mouth, but don't say any words.
Hello, I am a homo.
I'm having a blast with this shit. It's a lot of fun. That was me. I'm not a homo. I mean, that was me. I'm... Okay, one time, but I needed the ride. Now, Brandon and I, we've never met before, so he doesn't actually know it's me, and I'm assuming it's him. You're drinking some red wine, I see. What happened to your shirt, dude? What happened? Is that blood or is that wine?
Nothing.
I'm not going to do this to you, Brandon. You got red on your shirt.
I know.
Oh, you fucker, I was going to do that to you. God damn it. That's like heroin to a comedian. Not that I've ever done heroin. All right, so... Brandon, we're going to do a trick with a borrowed $20 bill from you. If you have $100, it's funnier, but a $20 will work.
I have a $20.
Check your wallet. Maybe you have one you don't know about or something. All right? Cool. Dude, fucking wipe your nose. I'm not fucking around. What do you got? A one? He's got a single. That's it. One single. Who has one fucking single in their wallet? Living the dream, huh, Brandon? Did you give him that dollar? Are you his parents? You are. In case you have to make a phone call. It's like Barney Fife. You give him one fucking bullet. Maybe I can get 20 from your dad. Dad, I need to borrow a 20. Okay? And I'm not like him. I'm not fucking begging for it. All right. Jesus, look at the money he's got, right? 100's funnier. No, you keep the... He's got like a stack of fucking hundreds that thick. Sorry, I didn't mean to point that out either. No, that was stupid. Now you're going to be walking outside. Oh, there's that guy, Brandon's dad, who has $1,000 in his pocket on the left. And then, bam! You're dead, and they're rich. How easy could that be? All right, now. Yeah, is that your wife saying that? Yeah. Don't laugh, ma'am. They'll rape and kill you, all right? That's just the way it goes. I didn't fucking do the rules. Now, let's have this examined, and you look trustworthy. Examine that 20 for me. Good. Now, no, go ahead. It is an order. I got you again, didn't I? I'm fucking with you. No, I'm not going to. Take it. I'm not going to. Three. One more time, you are officially retarded in this state. You don't want it. Good. That's good. Because then we take your drink away. We give you a juice box, and we put your headgear back on, and then nobody fucks with you because you have the strength of an ape. Now, Brandon, I'll show you what we're doing. If this is going to make you nervous that we're using your dad's money, and I sense that it is, no, let's just skip this. We have other shit to do, all right? All right, now, let's look at some of the shit your dad just bought. The first trick is called the Chinese linking rings, or as they call them in China, the Chinese linking wings. Fuck, are they creepy. Not just one or two of them either, every fucking one of them. And they all have squinty eyes and buck teeth. Why?
No,
I'll show you. I could be wrong. I'm not a scientist. As you can see, they're already linked. There's a time saver. Unless I don't want them linked. Solid metal through solid metal. Not real hard for a good magician to do. But watch what happens when you try to pull those apart. Brandon, try to get them apart for me, please. Okay, give me those fucking things. Pieces of shit. Made in China crap. Fuck them. And fuck you too, Brandon. That's 20 minutes out of my show. I don't give a fuck. I've seen it. Quite frankly, I'm not impressed. It's Somebody better learn her fucking cues. Brandon.
Yes, sir.
Oh, there you are. Look, I need your help. I got to get more material. Just come over here for a second. Just stand behind the microphone for a second. I'll be right back. Okay. Just tell a joke.
I would like to tell a joke. I would like to tell a joke. I would like to tell a joke.
Why can't Stevie Wonder read?
Why can't Stevie Wonder read?
Because he's black.
Nope.
Say it. It's a joke.
Nope.
You don't say it. It's going to be fine. The whole thing. Just say
not saying it.
Why? He's blind. Just say he's because he's blind.
Oh, because he's blind.
What the fuck did you think I said?
Nothing.
No, I know what you fucking think I said. Give me the microphone. God damn it, Brandon. Good going. 1 minute you turn this into a fucking Klan rally. Come here, my racist friend. How many black people do we have? Clap your hands. All right, I think we can fucking take them. You lucked out this time. You lucked out. Let me tell you a story that's going to help you with your problem, Brandon. I used to live in a three-story house in San Francisco. No, I'm not gay. Top floor of the house, me. Middle floor, a black family. Bottom floor, a Hispanic family. Nobody ever told jokes like that. We got along. Until the earthquake came and leveled the fucking house. And guess who survived?
You.
Yeah, I was at work. Ma! Pow! Yeah, this is fun, huh? Yeah. Okay, Brandon, I need a 20.
You got one. My dad gave it to you.
Okay, we'll use one of my own. Fuck, I don't have one. That sucks. Well, that means we're going to have to skip to the card tricks. All right, now. I want you to examine that deck of cards for me. While you're doing that, I'm taking this rubber band and putting this girl's eye right fucking out. Look at me, ma'am. Put your fucking hand down and look at me. Yes. If you grit your teeth, it scares them. You fucking look at me! Okay, she's not going to do it. Ordinary deck?
Yes, sir.
Really? Seriously? Holy shit, it is. That would have fucked me up good. This is the deck we need. Now hold that. When I ask for it back, make it snappy. It's a rubber band. Make it snappy. Because rubber snaps. Okay, look, fuckers. That's a borderline genius joke. And it deserves a better response than that. So we're going to do it again until it gets it. And again and again. And when I ask for that back, make it snappy. All right. You'll find the show goes smoother if you just cooperate the first time. Ordinary deck?
Yep.
Then explain this. You can't do that with an ordinary deck. There's no fucking way. You got to put a string through every single card. It's a pain in the ass. It takes me all night. Luckily, I don't sleep much. Now, Brandon,
yeah.
You ever blow bubbles when you were a little kid?
Nope.
Hey, Bubbles, is this a guy or what? Well, obviously one of you are lying. Go ahead. $50 a night I got to pay that fucker. Just for it's worth every penny, isn't it? Fuck yeah, I could be feeding a starving kid for that. This is funnier. You could ask that starving kid, even he'd tell you, yeah, fuck, I'll skip a meal, do the clown. Pick one, I'll tell you what it is. What? Oh, I'm fucking looking at him. Yeah, all right, fine. We'll try it this way then, but it doesn't always work. Take one out. Yep, there, this is what I'm talking about. I have no fucking clue what that would be. I'm not fucking around, Brandon. I really have no idea.
Good.
What the fuck do you want from me, Brandon? You want to see a trick?
Yep.
Okay, then put it in the middle of the deck. Put it in the middle of the deck. Good. It's not your fault. I picked you. Not only will I cause your card to rise to the top, but I've changed it to the instructions for the cards. What the fuck is this doing in there? Why is that fucking in the deck? That's brand new. Okay, here's another one. All right, you want to see another one? All right, fine. Brandon, pick those up. No, name any card that comes to your head, except for the Ace of Clubs, which you were just going to say, weren't you? Fuck, yes, you were.
Two of Diamonds.
That Two of Diamonds. Would you flip over any one of the face-down cards or the cards that got stuck in the sign and show the audience which card you picked? Show them. Oh, fuck, if that was the Two of Diamonds, you would have fucking freaked out, motherfucker. Yeah, he would have, and you would have, too. And I would have. I would have. There's got to be a way to do that. Fuck, no, that's impossible. There's no way. This place would be packed out if I could do shit like that. I do rope tricks. Rope tricks can't be faked with magnets or wires like a lot of other tricks. Come on. Fuck, come on. We're running out of shit for real. Brandon, I need you to drop the card in the rubber band. You're confusing me holding that shit. Now, blow that up for me, please. It's got to be really big. All right? You ever have a balloon break in your face while you're blowing it up? It's not funny. It fucking hurts. I hear it every night. Fuck, that hurt. No, big. It's got to be really big. You'll know when to stop. One more big one. We're done. What the fuck? That is so much bigger than the picture on the box. Okay, wipe off the spit. Okay, now, let's see if this will work. I think that it will. Fuck, yeah. It's hot up here. Nice, thank you. Now, why don't you enjoy some of these fresh peanuts, Brandon? Open it quickly, because they're really, really fresh. What the fuck are you doing? They're peanuts. You're spilling them everywhere. We got to work up here. You're paranoid. Nobody's up here to get you. Come here, relax. Now look. You didn't even try these. Have a few. Brandon, they're peanuts. What are you afraid of? Is it snakes? It's snakes. You thought snakes were going to be in there. You shouldn't be afraid of snakes. What you should be afraid of is a clown sneaking up behind you with a knife. I'm fucking with you, Brandon. There isn't one person in 10 years who hasn't looked behind them. Fuck, if I have the budget for that, you'd be dead right now. I have to show you this. I got pulled over last night by the cops. They found a baggie of what appeared to be cocaine, right? What a bunch of dicks. Well, no, if you're a cop and you don't know the difference between meth and coke, you shouldn't be a fucking cop, right? So they handcuffed me. Oh, ouch, that hurt, right? I'm a fucking magician. I was out in like 30 seconds. They weren't real impressed. They pulled this shit out. Watch this. Go like this. I'll show you what they did to me. Yeah, put your fingers. They told me, yeah. Never mind. They told me 17 inches of electrical tape wrapped around anyone's fingers can subdue the prisoner no matter how fucking violent that they are. So he proceeded to do that. He told me that even Houdini couldn't escape from this. So now watch this, Brandon. He did both hands like that. See if you can get out of that. It's fucking hard, isn't it? Oh, you fucker, how'd you do it? Okay, I did something wrong. Come here, do this again. It's that fucking spring action thing you have going there. I'm going to fucking tape that down, Brandon. There, now you're fucking not getting out of this. I just want to make sure the girl in my hotel room is still going to be there when I get back tonight. Okay, I think that's how much he did. All right, now try to get out of that. What are you doing? How the fuck? Okay, Brandon is a superhuman. Dude, come up here for a second. You. I don't know how the fuck he's doing that. go like this once. Yeah, I'm going to, if this happens again, I'm just going to, I should have got out. I should have just fucking ran. I didn't know. Instead of spending the night in jail and trying to work with a fucking sore ass. Don't use your side. You can't use your side. See, it's fucking hard, isn't it? Okay. Yeah, but you can do it, but it takes some amount of time. Okay, I'm going to try it again. Okay. All right, that's about good. Hold this. What the fuck? What the fuck just happened? I didn't tape my fingers on that way. Give me this. What the fuck? There. God damn it. Hold that. I'm going to get some scissors. All right, here. Shit. All right, God damn it. I'm not going to be able to get out of this. I don't know how the fuck you two did it. Thanks for helping me. You can sit down. You're staying though, Brandon. Brandon, put your feet closer to the ground. Good. I need to borrow a 20 or we can use my own. Make a fist like you're mad. That would be happy. That's happy. All right. That would be mad. That would be happy. This use the other hand. It feels like somebody else. The stranger. You ever try the stranger? Have you?
Nope.
Brandon?
Nope.
Brandon. Mom and Dad are here, huh? All right. I get you. I got you. Have you ever tried it? All right, two fists. We're going to go on one of your double dates you've never been on. Now, I'm going to fold his 20 two times, once in the center, once in the center again, and once on each end. That's twice. Doesn't matter how many times that was. Three kinds of people I hate, those who can count and those who can't. All right, now, I place this on one of his fists. This is a random... All right, now, random choice. I could have put it there, but I didn't. I put it here to prove to you it was random. Because your fists are identical, especially this one. Now raise that one up a bit lower. Good, right there. And put that fist down. No. Put it down. Put it down. Like, you're a dick, you're an asshole. Like, insult it. Write your own shit. Okay.
What
I think you got
beer?
The.
What? What about a beer?
Yeah, two beers. Bring them out. Coors Light, please. Okay. And some ice water.
Okay.
You smell good.
Thank you.
You don't have to thank me. Fuck, you smell good. Yeah. Mm. You smell like a little baby.
Okay, here we go. Here we go, baby.
Can you drink? Are you old enough to drink? You're old enough to drink.
Yeah.
What the fuck is this? Ice water. Fuck, never mind.
What's your name, Brandon? Look at you. Sexy.
Get off the stage. Leave him alone.
Bye-bye.
You get off.
Hey, no, I want to tell a joke.
Hey, no, that's not fucking happening. Bye.
Wait, come on.
No, you suck at telling jokes.
No, this is a super good one.
No.
Come on.
Okay, you done? No. No.
Come on.
Ooh, okay, you
like another bird.
Okay, you know what? You fucking deserve this. Go ahead. Yeah. Go on.
Okie dokie. Why did everybody want to play with the mushroom? Because they said he was a nice guy.
A fungi.
He was a nice guy.
A fungi. It's a fucking mushroom. It has to be a fungi. You said nice guy. How do you fuck that joke up even? You don't even get it now, do you?
No.
If you're going to tell a joke, do one you can remember, like this one. What's worse than finding a worm in your apple?
Getting raped.
Who the fuck is going to argue with that? We don't call it rape either. It's surprise sex. Sounds better. Here's to trust. You ever do LSD?
Nope.
Pack your bags. Someone's going on a little trip. Now, do you see any strings or wires?
Nope.
How about now? It's already starting to kick in, isn't it? Is there anything here?
Nope.
Is there anything here?
Nope.
All right. Nice laundry detergent, I think. It just smells clean and fresh like a baby. Now, how many wings do you see on that eagle?
None.
There's two. Yeah, good. I'm going to help you when the questions get rough. On any bird, there's two.
Okay.
One, they go in circles. Watch what happens when you say wings as loud as you can three times in a row. Go.
Wings, wings, wings.
Hello? That's not the trick. I'm fucking around. It looks like a phone. I just noticed. Like, wing, wing, wing. Hello? It's a joke. I'll do something later that isn't, and then you compare the two. Here's the real trick. Wings three times. Go.
Wings, wings, wings.
They call back. Come on. It could have been important. I won't do it again. That would make you retarded. Whenever you're ready, though, with the wing, wing, wing.
I'm good.
You're not doing it? I won't do it again. I told you. Look, I'm not here to make you look retarded. It's so crucial to the show.
Can't do it.
No, he won't do it. You know what? Let's... He doesn't trust me, obviously. I don't have his trust. I thought maybe we... Look at this. He's looking at my phone like I have a knife behind his back all the time. All right. So we'll do the other trick then. Magic dust. And then some magic dust. Then a bit more magic dust. What do you do for a living, Brandon?
I'm in the Air Force.
Air Force. Air Force. Air Force. Yeah, that's cool. You know how to fly a jet or a plane?
Nope.
No?
No.
Oh. What's the Air Force do then if you don't fly?
I'm in CE.
What?
I'm in CE.
CE, what's that mean?
Civil engineering.
Civil engineering?
Yes, sir.
Do they never fly?
No, they don't fly.
Really? Okay, cool. Okay, Brandon, now watch this. Because of the magic dust, the pieces of your 20 are now back together into one solid piece. Wait a minute, no, fuck, we never ripped it. Shit, we'll have to do that now then. What? I'm a fucking magician, chill out. Okay, look at the shirt. What does it say to you? Magic or gay. A lot of people think it means gay. You know, like someone yelled out on the way here tonight, "Would you do blow Elton John for that shirt?" I'm like, fuck you. I blew Elton John because he's a great entertainer. Don't you agree?
Sure.
Okay, now that's your receipt. You take that. Something happens to this, you got that. Put it in your pocket so I can't get at it. Top pocket, right there. No, you want it there?
Yeah,
fuck him, he's stubborn, isn't he? All right. I'm going to roll the rest of the 10 into a little ball. What, 20, whatever the fuck it is. Thank you very much. It's funny, huh? Enjoy your car accidents. It's bound to fucking happen one night. Someone's going to get in one. Last thing in their brain's going to be me shaking that fucking maraca, too. Motherfucker! The rest of the 20 roll up, placed inside of this pan here that I use on my farm to burn the sick baby chicks in. Who gives a fuck? They're sick. There's always a lot of them, so you gotta fucking cram a lot in there. Then the lighter fluid. Then, woof, up they go. Why is that funny to you? Why? It's horrible. It's not the fire they hate, it's the lighter fluid. It gets in their eyes, and they can't fucking reach it with their wings. That's where the comedy comes in. Hold that, Brandon. It's gonna be a big fire. We don't wanna take chances with this shit. All right, now, where's my lighter is wet. Shit, who has a Bic lighter? If you have one, just lob it up here. Don't whip it, underhand it. I can't see it till it's fucking here. So, if you have a lighter, before he dries off, underhand it up here. Someone's got it. Okay, good. Fuck, nice throw. That better been a chick. Okay, good. And I was like... I was like, does it work? Yes, good, perfect. Let's see if mine works now. Oh, yes, perfect, yes. All right, now. Brandon, it's not real lighter fluid. I wouldn't be dousing you like that if it was. Now. Fuck! My thumb was on fire. Did you see that? That's fucking cool. I'm fine, thanks. Look at your 20. Is it burning?
Yes.
It looks like it is, but is it?
Yes, it is.
Fuck. All right, it is. It's not supposed to. It's supposed to turn into a bird first and then burn. No, it's beautiful. It's like the rising of the phoenix. Only it doesn't rise. It flops around and screams. It's like the flopping and screaming of the phoenix. That's the first time that's ever happened again. That's going on the list of shit I can't do. You have another 20?
Hey.
What?
I thought of another joke.
Oh, you thought of another joke. Good. Keep it in your fucking head.
This is
No, don't come out here again. I just fucked up his 20.
Look at you.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Sexy.
Drink, she'll get prettier.
Yeah.
Excuse me, we're trying to do a show. Get off the stage.
I like you. Come on.
You ever see these in the Air Force? They're called whores.
You're the whore.
I'm the whore, yeah.
Yeah.
Get off the fucking stage.
Yeah.
When's the last time I punched you really hard?
Right before the show?
Right, so you're due, right? Get off the
no,
stage.
No, but this is a really good joke.
Bye-bye.
But you said I could do a joke if I put on your mommy's prom dress.
Shut the fuck up. Remember about that? It has nothing to do with this.
Hey, what about when you made me pee all
shut
over?
The fuck up. I didn't make you do anything. You get off the stage now. Walk.
You said I...
Bye-bye. Oh, really? I did that for you, fuckwits. Did you forget already the first joke? You know what? You fucking deserve this. Tanya, come tell your joke. I changed my mind. Now you're fucked. Not a chance in hell. Get the fuck off now. Oh, that just happened. Whose show is this? Oh, it's mine. No. Don't you ever second guess me like that again. That's how we rock up here, huh? Fuck yeah. Keep the bitches in line.
Yo, keep the bitches in line, yo.
Are you on the offstage microphone?
No.
Oh, great. Tell the joke that if you're going to do it anyway, better be fast.
Okay. Oh, okie dokie. What is the pirate's favorite letter in the alphabet?
Q.
Oh, fuck. What is the pirate's favorite letter in the alphabet? No, you think it'd be R, but it's the C we love. All right. Go ahead and lift that up and see if your 20's in there. Nope. Okay. Get the ashes. We need a pinch of the ashes. Now, rub the ashes on this lemon. By doing that, the magic happens. Rubbing the outside with the burnt 20 produces, watch your feet, the 20 inside of the lemon. The proof? The corner that's in his pocket's gonna match the corner that's missing from this. Uh-huh. You don't think I've seen the show 100 fucking times. I can't get that out of there, Paul. You're the king. Now, the thing to remember is not to rub your eyes with lemon juice on your fucking hands. God damn it. It's a good thing I don't feel pain like most humans. Now, the corner is missing from this 20. I purposely ripped the serial number off with his piece so that he could match it to the serial number that's written on the other side. Go ahead and do that and tell me, is it exactly the same one we burn?
Yes.
Really? Fuck yeah. All right, but it's still ripped, and this show is all about perfection. Trucks for you fuckers. So how do we fix a rip 20 with this, the magic silk of India? Yeah, go on, patronize me. It's because you don't know what the fuck this can do. What if it could kill a big group of smartasses? You, ma'am, do you like birds? That's a keeper, huh? You have to be proud. But now it's in this neat little carrying case. There you go. That's yours. Now, if you were to take the tape off of that when you get home tonight, you'll be surprised to find it's no longer ripped. You would be surprised. Right? Fuck yeah, okay? You call me if that happens. Wing, wing, wing. It's all come full circle. Look, put that away. I don't flaunt your failures in your face. We have gifts for you. Tanya, bring out his gifts.
I got the gifts.
I know you do. Bring them out.
Okay.
You're going to like this.
I got show
tickets. You're ever in Vegas. We got what? 4 tickets to the Blue Man Group.
Yeah.
You spent more than $100 on that.
No way, no way, no way. These were free, free, free.
They don't give out free tickets.
That's what they told me. They don't give them out. But I got it because I'm winner, winner, chicken dinner.
Give me these. How the fuck did you manage to get front row seats to see the Blue Man? Oh, fuck.
That was a high one, huh?
Are you finished? Now go get his gifts.
He doesn't know.
You, on the stool back there, go get him.
The gifts?
You fucking go get him now.
Yeah.
Here, listen to this tape while she's gone. Bring him out. What the fuck was that? You bring them out on a tray, like in rehearsals.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. So, I will kill the bitch. There's a DVD there for you. Here's your book. Okay, look, let me tell you what this is. First of all, the DVD is the live show. This one, that's you on there. Yeah, we have a fucking time machine. We could kill Hitler, but this is more fun. It's the shirt. Now, that is the back of the shirt. That you wear in the back. Because the front says, fuck yeah. And it's got your name on it, too. I think that's how you spell your name. I'm not going to do that to you. Oh, fuck! Oh!
Like no other theater, no other comedy club has this energy, you know? That's why I left Vegas. Because my theater happens to be built on an Indian burial ground or something, and there's no energy at all. So this is a treat for me to play here.